Morning to all of you.
Very warm welcome to you, sir. Very good morning and welcome to all our participants who have joined us today. The dignitaries who are present here, dear participants, and my dear colleagues as well. Today in this session, we have with us Dr. Rakesh Kriplani, who is a cyber psychologist and Emeritus Research Faculty, Resource Faculty, the School of Criminology and Behavioral Science, Rashtriya Raksha University. Dr. Rakesh Kriplani has been selected as an advisor to the 3G Group Dubai, the 3G School of Applied Psychology and Artificial Intelligence, towards global footprint and contributions. Also, Dr. Kriplani has been awarded very recently. He has been awarded by the Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, Shri Bhagat Singh Koshyari, for his outstanding contributions during the COVID situation. He has been awarded for his contribution in mental health as COVID warrior during both the waves of the COVID 19 that we have witnessed. So we sincerely welcome you, sir, and we are really honored to have you here. Please, over to you, sir, for your session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. On a formal note, thanks to all of you and Department of Adamas University for inviting me and giving another opportunity to interact with students, researchers, and scholars here. And today we have a very short time, and this short next half an hour to 1 hour, we'll be discussing about various aspects of cyber psychology. It will be more beneficial for the students as well as for the scholars also to understand this new upcoming field of cyber psychology, which we have been doing from last many years. So before I come up with the PowerPoint, I'll just give you a small introduction, like how did it evolve and what exactly cyber psychology basically consists of. So when we talk about cyber psychology, so many of the common person, they say, okay, you're talking about cyber security. So I say it's not about cyber security. I'm talking about cyber psychology. Even if you interact with the principals of schools, they will say, yeah, we had a workshop on cyber security recently. But this is not basically only cyber security. We are talking about the preventive aspect, preventive medicines of cyber security problem, we can say, like why things happen, what is the root cause behind all this thing. So there is always a cause and effect relationship when we talk about any science. So the causative factor of cyber crime or any other cyber related problem lies basically into the cyber psychological aspect. So it's not a very old field of around 50, 60 years, but around 20, 30 years back, it started with various countries, and now slowly, gradually, it has developed as a new field, upcoming field, and a career also. Various careers, which I'm going to tell you at the end of this session, like what sort of careers you can go for this thing. So I think in 2008 or 7, so at that moment, there was Orkut. So many of you may remember the Orkut was there before WhatsApp. WhatsApp came in 2010. And when Orkut was there, people used to go and chat there and just have a sharing, few sharings, and used to go at net cafes. So during that time, I just came across with a very important concept or idea in my mind, like how we can go for a digital mental health. And for that, few people from abroad, they landed to Nagpur and they came down to me. They stayed here for 4-5 days. And basically, they wanted to have that concept from me. Since I was not aware at that moment, I was quite new. 8 to 10 years back, I started my field. Digital mental health was a new term at that time. So it was a very hidden term. So somebody told me from US that you go for patent first and then you deliver this content to them. I said, okay, no issues. But during that 5 days interaction with these people, those were from the very top-notch IT companies of US, I came to know there is something big coming in the next 3-4 years. The next 2 years, I saw WhatsApp was there. And WhatsApp revolutionized everything. The complete scenario changed after 2010. And from since that time, I was trying to pursue from 2008 to up to 2015-16, I was trying to convince all the commissioner of police, home ministers and department bureaucrats that this is a field called cyber psychology, we should be promoted. And after many years, I got success and we came up with the first program on cyber psychology with Nagpur police. And we invited around 450 principals there. And these 450 principals, around 225 principals, They immediately after the session, they said, we need a separate session for our students in our school. So that was a success at that moment. And then department approved that thing slowly, gradually. Then I came up with various institutes, various colleges. And now we have a center of excellence for cyber psychology at Rashtriya Raksha University, the only police university in India. Then along with that, we are coming up with more one university from North India. We came up with Dublin, where we have a now center for excellence for cyber psychology. Now we have at Slovenia also, Bahrain and Slovenia. And very soon we are coming at Dubai also. So now in Pan India, from this smaller city, B town, or from the Pan India process, we have reached to the European countries as a pioneer in cyber psychology. So it was a long journey of around 12 to 14 years, and then it has been approved. So I will just give you a crux of what exactly cyber psychology is. And today, after this thing, many of you will try to check your mobile also. I'm sure you'll be just be more sensitized about this thing. What's happening with your mobile? What's happening with your laptop? You're not aware about what are hidden things in that. So let's start with the session. And I'll just share the screen with you. So today, apart from what few researches are there, because yesterday I was just preparing all the research work and other thing, then I was just more curious about this thing, who are going to the participants here. So I just asked the head of the department, Mrs. Swas, that who participants are going to be there. She said students are there. I said ki more of technical and more of graphs and other things would definitely make them bore in the moment. So they should know what applied things are there, what are the applications of cyber psychology, so that they can pursue as a career. So I made it in a different way then. And now we are going forward. We'll have some research topic also, but more of cyber psychology scope also. So when we talk about cyber psychology, as I said, cyber security and cyber psychology goes hand in hand. So cyber psychology is a multidisciplinary approach. Basically, it's an eclectic approach with various departments, right from economics, right from geography, history, IT, sociology, all are interconnected with cyber psychology. Right. So when we talk about cyber psychology, what are the contents of cyber psychology? How we go when we talk about cyber psychology? So one needs to understand the generation aspect first. We try to understand the students as well as the corporates or okay, what types of generations are there. So generation has been divided into five categories now. So there is one generation called baby boomers. Basically, baby boomers are 1945 to 1960. So these people are those your grandparents, your in-laws, those who have seen the freedom fight, the partition of India, the struggle of survival was there. And they're very hardworking, independent, passionate, resourceful, and work-centric people. These are the people, those who have knowledge of living in a simple living in high thing, which is very useful in pandemic now. So they have that knowledge. These people are very disciplined people. They wanted their dinner at 8:30 in the night, breakfast at 8:30 in the morning, sleeping at proper 10 p.m. at night, waking up at 5 a.m. in the morning. So these people have a very better quality of life. So now all different generations have different type of behavioral pattern in cyber behavior. So these people also have a different type of cyber behavior. So a lot of cyber crimes also varied basically with generation to generation. Like these people, they are sent a lot of times links also, certain links which are very malicious ring, we can say, or vulgar rings are there, and they get trapped into some blackmail or extortion that. So generation baby boomers is there, and generation baby boomers, there is generation X. Generation X is basically from 60 to 80. So 60 to 80 generation is generation X. So this generation is something which you have seen the old movies of Dharmendra and Amitabh Bachchan and other people. So this generation is basically those who have a gap between the parents and child. There was a generation gap coming up and they wanted to be independent. They wanted to be entrepreneur at that moment. And that the distance between the parent and child started increasing. So generation X, another generation, generation Y is again from 80 to 2000. People born between 80 to 2000, this is called millennials also. So this is a generation who saw basically the entry of TV, color TV, as well as the internet also. All this was basically bought in generation millennials. And millennial, now this word is very common abroad, everywhere, millennialism and millennials. This is a generation who wanted to have an Indo-Western fusion, like they wanted to have Western concept also, Indian concept together. They wanted to share life in that way. So generation millennials, generation Y is there. And then generation Z, people born after, children born after 2000. So these are generation who you may be a professor, a teacher or a lecturer or a parent at this moment. So generation Z is basically a child who is born with 4G concept, we can say. Like we can say generation X is 2G, Y is 3G, and basically generation Z is 4G. On the day one, they open up their fist. Day one. So their development is very fast. Their puberty comes at 8.5 years of age. So earlier it was 14 years. Now puberty is escalated now. So this is generation basically who wanted to have again a more fusion life of Indo-Western thing, and they wanted to work for 5 days and then they wanted to party at the 6th day, and the 7th day they wanted to do yoga and meditation. So this is a generation who has saw all this type of 5G and 4G and 3G generation, all sort of development in internet when they were born. At that moment, everything was there. WhatsApp was there, internet was there. So generation Y is 2000 and later on. And generation Alpha, that's 2010 and later on born children. This is again a 5G generation. So the generation Alpha and generation basically Z, both have a difference now. So now you can see that generation has started shrinking now. Within 5 to 10 years, generation has changed. So if you have a child at home of 5 years of age and a 15 years child, you can see the difference. This 5 year child is more intelligent. So we can see the difference of relationship, like, so earlier generation X and Y, then they used to be in college, then they used to understand the concept of relationship and affair and love and all this in proposal. Generation Z came up with 11th and 12th, and generation Alpha, now they propose in class 1st and 2nd. So in class 4, I have girls, those who have caught seeing porn in the school, in the mobile. They bought the mobile in school and they were sharing with each other. So this is generation Alpha, where now they know exactly what is the meaning of proposal and how to propose in class 1 and 2. So this is all the category of generation. So when we talk about cyber psychology, we try to make understand students and companies and corporates and government, like what types of generations are there and what type of problems they believe into and they can get trapped into. This is one part. So the another part, what is important in cyber psychology, is the type of parenting. So parenting also has changed in last few years. So one parenting which was there in 1980s in US called helicopter parenting. So later on they came to know that it was a failure parenting. What is helicopter parenting? Helicopter parenting somewhere where a parent tried to hover around the child. They just basically like move like a helicopter on the child. They do the micromanaging of the child. Each and every, these are the parents who drop the child at the basketball court, but they don't leave the basketball court. They stay there only because they feel if the child fell down, I need to take care of that. So they are basically the having a completely a parachute as a first aid kit with them, always on the rescue mode. So helicopter parenting, they came up in US in 1980s. And after 20, 30 years, they came to know this was a failure parenting because the output was there, the outcome was there. The children were not developed as an adult. The adulthood was not developed. They were not able to take their own decisions and problem solving skills was not there because their problem was solved by the parents. Their battle was fought by the parents. But in India, we started in 2000 now. In 2005 onwards, we have started the helicopter parenting, and you saw a lot of parents, those are hovering around the children nowadays with complete micromanaging. So what is the difference between helicopter parenting and normal parenting? If I ask a generation Y or X parent earlier, what is the routine of your child? They may say, okay, he goes to school, come back at 4 o'clock, then he'll have a dinner and go for tuition. That's over. That's the simplest language. But helicopter parent will say, no, he wakes up at 6:05. No, sometimes at 6:10. So when he does his brush with the right hand, he takes around 6 to 7 minutes. Sometimes with the left hand, he takes around 7 to 8 minutes. When he dips a biscuit with Oreo, then he takes around 5 minutes. Sometimes with the Marie biscuit, it takes around 2 minutes. So all the micromanaging, what type of biscuit he eats, which hand used for the brush, and how much time he takes. So helicopter parenting has two parenting. One is Rambo Hawk parent, and one is called the rescue parent. So we elaborate all this. The Rambo Hawk parent is a parent who has always AK-47 in his hand. He goes into college and the school and basically fires the principal first. Why this thing happened with my child? Earlier, the X and Y generation, if a child fails, the child was scolded. Now, if a child fails, the school teacher and the professor is scolded. Why my child got failed? It's because of your administration and your educational policy, my child has failed. So this is called the Rambo Hawk parent. So we elaborate basically what helicopter parenting consists. Now, this is basically the pre-pandemic era. So nowadays, when we talk from last 1.5 years, so there are two eras now. One is the pre-pandemic era, and one is the pandemic and the post-pandemic era. So now BC and AD has changed now. That is before March, after March. So now this is happening. Now the pandemic part has come. So the helicopter parenting, which was there, now it has shifted into the pandemic parenting. So pandemic parenting, what has happened? A wife who is to complain, husband, throughout last 10, 15 years of marriage, you don't give attention, you don't give time to me. Now 24 hours, the husband was at home. Now the problem is, why don't you go outside? All day I'm with you, I cannot bear you at this moment. The conflict started there. The children, child is at home, the mother is at home. One is busy with laptop, one is mobile, one is the YouTube. Everybody busy at home. The pandemic parenting has its own pros and cons. Initially, I'll let you know initially what happened when the lockdown started. Everybody was happy last March. Okay, they were preparing pizza, pani puris and gupchup and all these things at home. So they used to have a lot of kirana and used to eat at home. And they used to think it's a picnic for 2-3 months. Corona will go after 3-4 months and we'll have vaccination, everything will be settled. They were not expecting that even after vaccination, the second wave will come, third wave will announcement there, and the financially economical problem would start. So initial period was good, but after a few months, after the first wave ended, and when they thought now it's not going to go back, Corona is going to stay for longer years, then the pandemic parenting problem started, and then the side effect of the online education, the side effect of the fatigue, COVID fatigue at home, chronic fatigue which was there, that started among the family, and now we have rise in psychological problems, and the psychological pandemic has started in India now. I'll explain you what is psychological pandemic. So when talk about birth of cyberspace and cyber psychology, so basically we say ki, basically few years back, decades back, the first word which was used before internet was that was basically ARPANET. ARPANET was basically, it was just to talk, talk among the nuclear scientists. Then ARPANET converted into internet, and then browsers came in, and the browser called WWW, World Wide Web came in. And the word cyberspace was termed by William Gibson, a novelist. He gave this word called cyberspace. So cyberspace, what is cyberspace basically? So when you see at the sky, you see a moon there. This moon is basically your WWW, World Wide Web, internet. So you know only that dot of that complete cyberspace. The complete dark space besides the moon, alongside the moon, that is the cyberspace. And if there is an alien, if there is an alien planet, somewhere life exists in another planet, so basically that is the dark net, which you are not aware about. So you know only 10% of the complete cyberspace. 90% you are not at all aware about. So birth of cyberspace and cyber psychology took up, and basically like just like brain, it was prepared, the computer was prepared, the same context, the neurons, synapses, it was prepared in that way only, it was completely constructed in that way. So cyber psychology architecture, when we talk about cyber psychology, the architecture of cyber psychology is very important. There are dimensions of cyber psychology. So we talk about physical dimension, reality dimension, temporal dimension, text dimension, sensory dimension, interactive dimension, social dimension, and identity dimension. So there are various dimensions which needs a lot of research, which are already researched now. And basically the most important dimension is the identity dimension. So at this moment also, we are all going through the problem of identity. What you post, what you don't post, what you share, what you don't share, what you like, what you don't like, and your actual behavior and online behavior, virtual behavior and offline behavior, the total are different number of times. So basically, like if I say a small part of identity dimension where you have a lot of problems, there is a concept called black hole concept, black hole experiences. So you send somebody a message and there is a blue tick there. Double blue tick is there, but the person didn't respond it to you. Now you have a complete jerk in your mind. You started thinking he has ignored me. It's an insult. He's avoiding me. And a lot of assumptions come up. After that, you think I've never talked to this person because he ignored my message from last 2 hours. Afterwards, he calls you up and he says, sorry, I was in ICU. My mother is admitted in COVID ICU and we have a lot of problems. Oh, I'm sorry. But these 2 hours, there was a complete black hole. complete blank things in your mind and you started doing assumptions. So there are a lot of different researches called online dissemination effect. Online dissemination effect means on real life, you may not post something or comment on particular thing, but offline, you may go there and post something hatred, religious, antisocial, anti-national message, and you'll close down the laptop or mobile and you think, no one has seen me, I'm invisible. So there are two types of online dissemination. One which is toxic, where you go for trolls, aggressive messages. One is benign type and altruistic messages, where you wanted to help somebody online without knowing the person, without any output of that thing. At home, mother is asking a child, go and have, let's bring a medicine for me. He says, I'm busy. But online, somebody has put me, ki, I need a maid servant. And he's sharing the numbers for the maid servant. You know, maid servant and beauty parlor numbers and the recommendation are shared there. So here he's not giving the medicines to the mother, but there maid servant numbers and beauty parlor numbers being shared by the particular man or woman. So this is what called online picture. And this needs a lot of research. A lot of research has been conducted by many things like Solar and Guten. Many researchers are there we're going to talk about if we get time. So when you talk about cyber psychology again, the most important thing is brain and mind. As you all know, psychology students are there. Without this, we cannot understand any concept of psychology because these are the two pillars. So brain, let us consider now brain as an hardware and mind as software. Okay, so brain grows up to the age of 16 and a half years of age. We have two right and left hemisphere interconnected to each other. Different chips are there. So we can see the brain during the operation. We can see, okay, this is what brain is. So this is the hardware part. So there are certain chemicals in brain which is responsible and which has some correlation with our behavior, dopamine, then serotonin, then endorphin and oxytocin. Many chemicals are there. So let us keep hardware part aside. We'll talk within a minute. Another part is mind. So mind is software. We cannot see mind, but it works. Like we cannot see air, but we still feel. Mind is also a software. So we have two mind. We have conscious mind. We have subconscious mind. Conscious is 10% and subconscious is 90%. So if I'm reading this thing, brain, mind, concept, this is the aware part. This is only 10%. And throughout the day, I'm only aware for 10% what I'm going to read and what I'm going to do. 90% of the time, we are dealing with a subconscious mind. All the good and bad, all bitter experiences, failure, achievement, all get stored into the subconscious mind. All the files are there with name, without name, with file, without files. Now, since it's a file, it's a software, it's a Google of basically our system. So all files are there. So there is, if there is a virus entry into that, if there's a virus file enter into that, it starts corrupting the other files. It can corrupt any files. It can corrupt your health file, sleep file, sexual file, academic file. It can corrupt any file and start buffering them there. It starts buffering there. It gets hanged there and it starts giving message to the brain. And what brain does? Brain starts doing imbalances of the chemical. What we call chemical locha in Hindi number of places. Okay, after Munna Bhai MBBS. So it starts creating chemical locha, chemical imbalances. So this chemical balances starts give suggestions to the body then. It gives suggestion to the your intestine, maybe gut problem there, or maybe some acidity, refluxes, or it can increase your blood pressure, or whatever bodily. So this is called the psychosomatic problems or psychological induced problems into the body. So this mind, this virus is there into the society also, into the family also, into the individual also. So in India, since mental health is the least thing now, the last thing we think about mental and dental. So we are less concerned about these two things. So for example, for dental also, if a person whose earlier teeth was white, it became yellow internally, he thinks, who is seeing? I know it's yellow inside. Later on, there is a cavity. He thinks, okay, still I'm eating my food. And later on, when this cavity strikes and then he has a hand on his face and he runs to the dentist. Same thing happens with us also. Initial, there is some little bit aggressive behavior. There is some tantrums or something. We think, okay, what's wrong with that thing? Later on, when the person is, when he sees he's going to lose his job or his relationship, then he runs to a psychologist or a therapist because he thinks, not the fear of losing part is there. So basically, we need to scan this virus. We need to install a new software into the mind and an antivirus into the system as well as into the family. So cyber psychology deals with both the things. Right, with the brain chemicals also, as well as with the mind also. For example, I will say, apart from dopamine, which you all know during this pandemic, because WhatsApp University was very big now in last this pandemic. Everybody came to know about dopamine, and every TV serial is talking about dopamine now. Every second serial, they are basically web series they are making on psychology. I will talk about oxytocin. This is the chemical which is a trust chemical. It's a bond chemical. So when I was in school, so there was an incident where there were two senior people sitting at a well, and I used to go there and talk to them. They were all 60s, 70s. And my family used to think, why you go and sit with these people? I was in class 10. But I used to listen to the stories, what they used to say. And I think just because of that input, maybe I became a smaller psychologist further on. So I one day what happened, one senior geriatric person, he was talking to another. And he said, ki that girl, she has come back and she's filing a divorce, and the relationship discords are there. So another person said, another senior person said, okay, you know what? If she delivers a child, the problem will be solved. So I interrupted between, well, what are you saying, uncle? If the husband is not able to take care of the wife, how is he going to take care of the child then? He said, you are too small to understand all these things. You go from it. Don't listen to all us. You are in school now. After 20, 25 years of my academics and practice, then I came to know what was the meaning of that particular thing. I came to know when wife delivers a child, husband secretes the chemical called oxytocin. So that's the reason why number of times wife says, after the child, my husband is normal now. He comes back properly at night. He stays. He is a good husband now, after became a good father, because the oxytocin was secreted. That's the bond chemical. Now, this same chemical in real life, now we are seeing there's a depletion. People are not able to connect nearby people with each other, with near friends or the building friends or somebody getting relationship into the near person. They go online and they try to connect to other person, and they feel that they have an oxytocin secretion. Even today also, whatever I'm talking to all of you, experience of 20 years of my experience and other thing, many of you will just go and search on internet oxytocin. A person lively, you're talking about oxytocin, will not believe on me, but somebody who has written a blog, whom you don't know, he is whether qualified or not for that thing, but you're going to believe that person because your online secretion of oxytocin is more rather than offline part. So there are many chemicals, and endorphin and many chemicals are there which are responsible for cyber behavior. We try to make understand how we can go for this, and researches are also going in. So as I said, we are only aware about the basically internet, www, world wide web. We are not aware about the darknet. Very few people may be aware what is the meaning of darknet. So darknet, I said, if there is a life exists somewhere, some individual or some authority or somebody who is invisible is trying to control your mind. He's trying to control your laptop, trying to control your psyche, and trying to control your mobile also. So what darknet does basically, I'll just give you. It's basically a spy in your pocket. It's a spy in your pocket. So 90% of people, those who are listening to me at this moment, around 228 are there, more than 150 or 200 people or those who are listening to me, their front camera must be on for 24/7 throughout the week. Your front camera is on and everything is getting recorded in that. Your audio also and video also, your personal movements, your extreme personal movements, everything gets recorded. You're not aware. You have downloaded few things, apps. And because of that app download, you have given access to the front camera. This is done by the darknet people. And your personal movements are sold to the pawn hubs, to the e-commerce platforms, and to the other countries where language is not accessible. So many of them, they are not aware. And the very simplest tip for this thing, how to avoid, because this is a social contribution to the society. You should just put up a bindi. Just put up your, basically, any sticker on your laptop or a mobile on the front camera so that your video should not go. You will not believe, last 2 years back, there was an arrest in Germany. Around 138 people were arrested, out of which seven were Indians. They were arrested by Europol, Interpol for child pornography. And these seven people, they revealed to the government of India that India has become number one in the world for child pornography. Second is Thailand, and third is Singapore. So Indian government was shocked about this thing, how this happened, and India has become a sex tourism country, child sex tourism country for abroad. And they took a very serious cognizance, and since last 1.5 years old, last we have seen government is very strict about child pornography, and it has become a non-bailable warrant after this revolution. So imagine this darknet people, what they do, a child who is playing a game, suddenly there is a pop-up. there is a pop-up and there is a second stage coming up. Child thinks he wanted to enter into second stage. He immediately clicks it, and the click is basically about the front camera access. And they start taking the photographs. And this is sold in other porn-up places. So basically, we talk about darknet and how your WhatsApp, your Instagram, your Facebook, your offline activities, and Tinder and Bumble and other, all these things. Sumona, I think...
Kindly mute yourself. Sandeep Sarkar? Mr. Sandeep Sarkar, please. Yes, now it is done.
Yeah. So basically, darknet is something, a very dangerous thing we need to understand. So games also, various games, like how they are creating psych in terrorism, like PUBG, Free Fire, and Call on Duty, Among Us. There are many games which creates basically a violent behavior in mind. And last year, before the lockdown, I admitted 3 children basically in psychiatric hospitals for PUBG addiction. And because they wanted to kill their parents, they wanted to slit the throat of the parents because they were not giving them PC, a big PC for PUBG. And during the lockdown period, pandemic period, suicides were there in India for PUBG. And fortunately, government basically banned because of the China collision. And another part, children took the basic solution for that. Also, they are playing now Korean PUBG with that thing. And very soon, now the Indian PUBG, Indian adaptation PUBG is coming up. So PUBG and all these games. So PUBG is only being basically rumored more as a blacklisted game. But apart from that, there are Free Fire, Call of Duty, and many other games which create problem. And they have different modus operandi to control your mind. So there are a lot of challenges. So there are challenges which are going on all over India, all over the world. And these challenges have a different psychology behind. So one challenge which is there, like water drinking competition. Like they have, who can drink much more water. So if they're not aware at that moment, drinking excessive water can be fatal. Drinking water excessive can be fatal. And there is basically international competition, US also water drinking competition. In the winner and second winner, number of times they get hospitalized because of the sodium potassium. So India also, many of them, they think, okay, you can drink 6 to 10 liters water and they can be a winner, but they can be admitted because of this sodium problem. So there are many challenges, like chubby bunny marshmallow came, where children, they put up marshmallow in the mouth and they get choked. And they get choked into that thing. And there is a butt chugging thing. Butt chugging is basically where young adults, they put up alcohol through the anal, through enema. And they wanted to see who can intake more alcohol through the anal part. And that can create a life-threatening problem in that moment. So there are a lot of challenges which are going on. And what psychological aspect goes beyond this challenge? What are the needs? What are the subconscious problem behind all these things? What makes you make them to enter into such challenges? This is a part of cyber psychology and the research part. Then addiction. What usually people think is the cyber psychology means mobile addiction. Whenever we talk about cyber psychology, they say, okay, you're talking about addiction. It's not only about addiction, it's used in various fields. So, but addiction is the most prominent thing. And every month we are seeing during the lockdown period, around 100% increase. Last pre-lockdown, I used to have around 10 to 12 cases per month. Now around 20 to 30 cases per month I am getting for mobile addictions and gaming addictions. So how to overcome addictions and how to counsel these children or adult, even adult also. So even they also are having problem basically with addiction. I have 3-4 cases where their marriage is having a problem because of their mobile gaming addiction. It's not only with children. So even corporates are also quite disturbed about this thing. A lot of people, their productivity has gone because of mobile addiction and they play mobile somewhere in the premises. So these are the few things. And when we talk about the pandemic, so pandemic, I'll just scroll on fast. So pandemic is not only the single pandemic. There are 5 parallel pandemics going on. One is the corona pandemic, which you all know, which is a viral pandemic. Second is basically the economical pandemic, which you all know because all businesses, employment, and you have been adjustment problem. Third pandemic is the infodemic pandemic. Infodemic pandemic, right from fake news, quackery, unscientific news, and riots, lynching because of WhatsApp. This is called the infodemic pandemic. It's also a big pandemic all over the world, right from ministers to the superstars to common men. They are suffering because of this wrong messages. And the fourth is called the psychological pandemic, which you all are feeling now, fatigue, lethargic, now at this moment, hanging, mind is getting hang, and somewhere uncertainty, doubt, fear, what's going to happen in future, what will be about your career, what about your children, all sort of uncertainty has come up. This is called the psychological pandemic. And the fifth pandemic is called the behavioral pandemic. So behavioral pandemic, you can see government has bought the vaccination, mask, sanitizer, everything, but behavior is not under control. Even after the second wave, the moment unlock has started in our city, lakhs of people are there on road now without masks. Again, they are inviting the third wave now, and they're not able to change the behavior. So government cannot change the behavior. That's the community outreach we have to do. Our own responsibility has to be taken of that thing. So now behavioral pandemic has come up after psychological pandemic. So these two pandemic, where all these psychologists, those who are listening to me, as parent psychologists, those who are listening to me, your role is a bigger role now. Because now to control the planet, to save this planet, to survive psychological pandemic and behavioral pandemic has to be taken care of. Viral pandemic is taken care of by the scientists. Information has been taken care of by the cyber people, and basically economic taken care of by the finance people. But what about the psychological and the behavioral part? Yeah. So now when we talk about post-pandemic, pre-pandemic, so earlier you all psychologists used to talk about emotional quotient. Now a new word which I have given, that is called digital emotional quotient. DEQ. So digital emotional quotient basically has various contents in that, and you have to be stable, empathizing people online, inspiring people online, controlling people online. This is going to be a new normal. So digital emotional quotient is something big part. Even with WEC, World Economic Forum, even now they have given that what new skills are required in 2020 onwards. So they have given different skills. Critical skills, complex problem skills, negotiation, judgment skills. These are all the new skills which I have given now. So there are contents of DEQ, like EQ, digital dexterity, change, capacity, many things which we try to basically cover when we talk about cyber psychology into application and research. So digital intelligence is also one part that includes the literacy, the rights, security, identity, use, safety, emotional intelligence, and your communication online. So that's called digital intelligence. So now emotional intelligence is basically shifted to digital emotional quotient. So new skills have to be adopted now, which adaptability has to be there. Your flexibility has to be there. A tech savvy has to be there. You need to have for digital transformation, and many other things are there. So you can see the creativity and flexibility, adaptability of Maruti and Mercedes company. Right from my childhood, I was listening that they only make cars. Now we came to know, okay, they are into breathing aids and ventilators also, because they are flexible, they are adaptable. Looking at the recession and market, they have shifted their vertical into another part also. So you need to go for a new world, a dream, a new world. You need to understand your data literacy, understand how to use your laptop and computer. You need to understand the cultural thinking of India. You need to understand the credibility of fake news, and you should know digital and coding skills. So coming to the career part, it's an interrelated subject. Mathematics, computer science, philosophy, economics, artificial intelligence, social media, designing, all the things are connected to cyber psychology. So apart from cyber psychology, I have came up with a concept called digital psychology. So by cyber psychology and digital psychology are two different things. Digital psychology, I have come up with the Institute of Dublin, Ireland, a behavioral training institute of Dr. Crimmins. So we bought digital psychology there along with IIIE Switzerland. They have come up with the digital psychology for University of Paris also, along with me. So behavioral economics and digital psychology comes now together. So there are different fields. So what happened? I'm not going to elaborate this thing because short of time. So there are four waves earlier. First wave, you all know about the agriculture wave. Different eras are there. Second was industrial. Third was the information age. And basically, fourth was basically this destabilizing and chaos, which is starting now. So information age was 1950s to 2021-20. And now, which is started recently, is the fourth wave. So that has different output, that has different transitions. So what basically fourth wave says, what was predicted? So electronic machines closely integrated with humans. And who will guide who? Will computers serve humans, or humans are going to serve computers? So this question is again, ball is in your court. You need to understand which who is going to serve who. So this is something which is connected to the fourth wave, which is now there. So cyber psychology is connected with all the waves now, which is coming up, and info revolution is coming up now. And info revolution has different technological evolution. And another part which is there called cybernetics. So basically cybernetics is something, a process of cybernetic device guided purpose to adjust machine or person's behavior. We both get adjust to each other. So this is called cybernetics, and which is now a part of your career later on. If you see in the further course, you'll find many careers connected to this. So this is called information age and mental age. When we talk about mental health, so there are three types of mental health problems, which is in information age: disorders of alienation, we feel alienated nowadays, disorders of consumption, what e-commerce is doing, disorders of emotional literacy. So there are three interrelated psychopathology of information age coming up with this part. So there are ecological consequences. As I said, this is connected to all the fields, even with the ecology also. So decreasing biodiversity, increasing pollution, and skewed resource allocation is also connected to the cyber part. So what a cyber psychologist or a person who is into cyber psychology can do? He can go for profiling of cyber criminals. Like there is a typical typology. Everybody has a typical typology. So we can see basically what type of typology is. There is the pioneers, scamps, explorers, game players, vandals, addicts are there. Psychological characteristics are there. So we can think about AI. So AI has different things along with that. Apart from 8 basic characters, cyber psychology is one part. You can enter into virtual reality, VR. So we have launched with a Kolkata-based company itself, one of the DC Vision company. We launched 2 products in VR treatment therapy as a psychotherapy. We are first and pioneer in India to launch this product. So we now in the further course for anxiety and phobia, you can use VR also as a therapy part. Then AI, as I said, industries are impacted with this part. Cyber security is one part, which is the most important. You can work in cyber police stations. In Maharashtra, our state government has announced in one of the program of mine that every police station will have cyber psychologist in future course. Slowly, gradually, we are coming up with Uttarakhand and many other states. We are interacting with all the states now. So maybe very soon, all states will have cyber psychologists. So in the cyber security department. So you can become a cyber psychology coach also. You can go to schools if you are not a master's in psychology. So you can become a cyber psychology coach. You can voluntarily work with the NGOs and work there to create awareness about cyber psychological problems as well as for the security problems. You can work in wellness centers, digital wellness, because addiction centers are going to come up. It has started. I have launched my addiction center, mobile addiction center 4 years back. Very soon, many cities, they are coming up with me now with mobile addiction centers. So digital wellness would be an important factor now. Then IT sector, like IT people, they are working on online content moderation is there. They wanted to delete all the negative messages from there. So they too have a lot of problems, and 2 or 3 companies there, they're coming up with IT and cyber psychology now. I said addiction clinics are coming up now. You can become a lecturer or a professor, because we are going to start, or people are going to start in various departments. All my students are going to be employed now with various departments, center of psychology. So even your college, other college, those who are going to start these courses, they will require lecturers also, professors also. You can be an author. You can write books on this thing. You can work with cyber cell police. You can work on digital psychology, the concept of behavioral economics and cyber psychology together. You can work with women child development projects and government of India with the department, because their adolescent and other things are there, and they are aware about the cyber security problems. They too wanted now program for women child development program. You can work for IB, RAW, and different things where cyber warfare is the part, and you can make them understand the psychology of the enemies or a person or the hacker or honey trapping. There are many things in cyber warfare which China is doing with us now. You can work with social sectors and NGOs where social media engagement now you need to understand. Digital psychology is the part where you have to understand the customer to sell the products. So same way social media engagement is there. And nowadays, a lot of psychologists, they are into blogging, they are into influencers, and they are selling products for them. So you can be in that also. You can be into virtual therapies. There are many sort of virtual therapies coming for Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, as well as basically along with this anxiety. School education as a school counselor there, because now initially there was a school counselor. Now you can have a specific school addiction counselor there, mobile addiction counselor in the school. So cybersecurity departments are starting in schools. And once the unlock is over, all schools are going to face a lot of problems with the children. They are not able to adjust in schools. So there is going to be a specialized area where school principals will require people, those who are having knowledge in cyber psychology. You can be bloggers and YouTubers also, putting up your own videos and creating awareness, earning money from YouTube, or writing something, blogs, and going for Reddit and other things. You can work with cyber law and psychology. Now, law is also considering psychology, and even for the mediations also, they are using psychology, even with cyber also. So cyber law, psychology, and forensics, they go hand in hand. So you can work in cyber law. You can be a cyber image consultant. Like earlier, it was only image consultant. Now you can be a cyber image consultant. If somebody wants to improve his image, her image online, so you can consult them with the psychological phenomena and theories, how you can create a good image online. That's the most important thing. You can be a cyber psychologist. You can be into robotics. So robotics and AI, these are two different things. Robotic is something, machine learning, machine intelligence there, where you can put up intelligence and cyber psychology, or cognitive engineer, or cognitive science and cyber psychology can be combined together, and you can work with Fortune 500 companies, Google and WhatsApp, because they are all coming with robots and AI things now. You can be a gaming specialist. So gaming is not always bad. It can be good also for brain and for body and for other things. A lot of games are coming up now. So you can be a gaming specialist, where you can put your input as a cyber psychologist. What game could be beneficial for the society, for the betterment of the society? Your expertise can be used in that. So you can be into design and cyber psychology also. All the mobiles that you're using, the cars, they are basically having design specialists. So now they want
I think there is a network issue.
Yes.
And there are some technological problems always. So
yes, sir has locked out for some reason, I think.
Okay, we will wait for some time and let him join. So participants, kindly be patient, as we know that technology has some disadvantages also due to some poor net connection or something. So kindly be patient. I'm sure he will be logging.
You can post your questions if you like in the chat box. Once sir joins us back, we can take the questions.
Right, I guess there was some problem there. Internet.
Welcome back,
or
sir.
Maybe all of people maybe got bored and they wanted just me to kick me out. That's the thing. Right. So apart from this, there are many other fields like robotics and AI, behavioral economics and cyber psychology is another part where both things get connected to each other, and you can work in that part also. So these are all the fields which we can work with as a cyber psychologist. It's a big area. Things to work upon. So I think with this part I will just end up, because I've already taken a lot of time of yours. So
no issue, you can continue. We are having 5-7 minutes more time, so no problem.
Yeah, we'll just put up for the questions if you want to have
yes, a number of questions are there. So thank you very much for this very, very informative and interesting session, sir. And okay, so there are a few questions like, can we virtually see the darknet?
You can see the darknet, but I'm not going to tell you how to see the darknet because it's quite risky. And you can get anything on the darknet, you know. right from getting a gun to your powder on cocaine and other thing in very at your doorstep. They will come to deliver at your doorstep without knowing the basic police system. So darknet is very dangerous. Nowadays, in last 3 months, I got 3 girls who procured drugs from darknet for 800 rupees. And in a small town like, so now these girls are basically from schools and colleges, less than 20 years of age. And somebody told them, okay, how to enter into darknet. So this is quite difficult to say on platform. Don't try to go into darknet. Once you access that thing, you will be surprised to see. You can get dead bodies also. You can get a complete tanker, a military tanker to purchase, a complete aeroplane to purchase there. Anything you think about in this world, you can get at your doorstep. That's a very dangerous thing.
Okay. All right. So next question, what are the roles of neurotransmitters in cyber psychology?
Obviously, as I said, key chemicals are responsible there, and neurotransmitters, there are a lot of research since it just, I'm trying to just hold on. I'll just show that thing if it starts. Let me see if it connects. So basically, neurotransmitters have definite role because all whatever I said, ki software has a problem that basically goes into neurotransmitters and cyber psychology. When you are basically on mobile, your neurotransmitters and other thing has a lot of effect on that. You slow down number of times, and this fatigue which you feel, just okay, it's on.
The fatigue which you feel or the drainage which you feel at the night if you have excessive mobile usage is because of the neurotransmitters which is creating problem. So it's a big topic usually when we talk about neurotransmitters and psychiatry and neurology. We did a lot of work here with psychiatry department and other things. So obviously it is affected. Okay. Is the voice clear with you, all of you?
Yes, sir. We can hear you. So another question, how... virtual reality can be a part of educational research. Means, how can we relate these two together and do a new research in this area?
Only thing, the most important place where virtual reality can be a part is education itself, medical and education. So you can definitely work into education sector. Like now, the few universities are coming up there in US, which is only virtual, complete virtual with VR sets. So you can search on internet, you can find out one university, they are putting a VR for every student. And so definitely it's going to have a pros and cons, both the thing. It's not only positive is going to be there, because when you put up VR, obviously you're playing with your mind at that moment. There is something which is illusionary things coming up. But like in Kerala also, there was one institute, one school which came up with the virtual part to show children how animals look and how basically you can see, you can feel that thing. So VR can basically, virtuality can make person feel that thing. And at distant plate, you can have a better education system. Now pandemic, like schools are closed down, everything is there. But other side also, you can see today I am there just because of this system platform. All over world, people are listening to me because of this Zoom system or whatever system you're using. Same with other part also. People can go for Yale University, Harvard University, where all world over university, they can join because of the VR. So VR is definitely a very good part. And there are a lot of work going on already in VR. We have started only with the clinical part, counseling part, that are two phobias, claustrophobia, other things. We are not into education, but we got few inquiries where people wanted to start something VR with education. So it's really a scope area.
Right. Thank you very much, sir. There is another very important question. How to motivate students to overcome PUBG addiction?
So, now this is all about creating awareness. First of all, when we did a tie-up with Bharati Vidya Bhavan school and we did, made a compulsory sessions for them, four sessions in 3 months for teachers, for parents and for students, we got a tremendous response. Pre-lockdown period, we got a tremendous response. Parents, they flooded with messages that our children came back home and they basically uninstalled the PUBG. They were trying to check the camera of mother and sister, so they were aware about that thing. So they need to create awareness. What happened? Usually what we do, we talk them on the social call. Ki don't play, you're wasting your time. Don't play, you study, don't play, you're going to get basically ruined with this thing. We don't tell them the scientific aspect. As I said, there is always a cause-effect relationship. We need to tell them what exactly happens, like the front camera concept. Wherever, whichever schools I have conducted more than 1600 workshops. So wherever I have conducted, all the students, they are sending throughout the day message to me, sir, I checked my mother's phone, I have put up a bindi there, I have put up a sticker there, because they were concerned about it. So that means these children, they are sensitized, they are sensitive, they know the responsibility. They need to have awareness about. So awareness is the most important part. Even government is thinking 1500% increase is there in cybercrime, 1500 during this pandemic period. It's a big number. 500% was for in first 3 months, now it is 1500%. So the only thing government is thinking is about the prevention part. Every city, every state, they need to go for preventive program for students, for colleges, for communities. So we are doing it. If you go on Facebook, you'll find daily I have 2 hours, 3 hours workshop. My students, they are doing workshops everywhere in every city.
Right. Sir, there is another very important question. At present, coding is included within the school curriculum. Do you think it could have any adverse effect on young people?
Now, there are two things now. How a child is basically using that coding, that's the most important thing. And it depends upon the parenting system. It depends upon what was oriented to him. Now, every child doesn't want to become a hacker. Okay, but in schools, whenever I deliver a workshop, out of around 400 students, 4 to 6 children, they come down to me and they ask me in a personal level, sir, I want to be a hacker. And they say, I want to be ethical hacker. I always say there is nothing called ethical hacker. Ethical chor naam ka koi cheez nahi hai. There is nothing called ethical thief. Thief is thief. So hacker is, so if you want to become a security professional, that is different. But ethical hacker is nothing. But a lot of children, they want to become an ethical hacker because they have certain demands in mind. When they see YouTube, they see the person is earning 6 crore, 10 crore, 15 crores. They feel it's an easy money thing. So again, family parenting, interactions at home depends upon what exactly, how he's going to use. If we go for minimalism, the post-pandemic period, so now we all need to go for minimalism now. Minimalism, what does mean what? Basically, we should go for simple living, high thinking. What Japan is doing. Japan is facing one problem called hakikomori, a very big problem in Japan, where the youth, they have confined themselves into the room. They don't want to come out of the room from years. It's not only in pandemic. From years, they are into the room and millions of youth are there. So Japanese government is not able to do anything for them. So they have basically denounced everything. So now in India, hakikomori have started. But we should go for minimalism, like thinking for a big car, iPhone 12 and all these things, all luxuries demand. They should minimalize now. And then the children will definitely go for a good human being thought process. And coding can be used for the betterment of the society. But if you talk in front of the child about crores and CRs and a lot of things, they feel they wanted money and a big number. And they feel easiest is basically hacking somebody. So they can use it.
Right. Sir, another very important question that these days, you know, children, they are having this constant online classes for which they use smartphone. But apart from that also, you know, they are using smartphone for a lot of other things as well. So right. How can we like motivate them to, you know, use the smartphone only for the education purpose and not for some other, purposes which can have an adverse effect? If you can please comment.
Right. So basically, keeping away from smartphone or mobile is impossible now. Okay, because already it has been given. And children, they are saying to me in counseling, sir, last year my school principal and teachers were saying, be away from mobile. And now when they want to earn money, they had given, okay, an online education is there. Even a parent also, now they are okay with 3.5 hour schools. So they are basically against this hypocrisy. So usually I tell parents, don't ask him to take your mobile, because if you want to control somebody's sugar, you don't have to eliminate sugar completely from home and you don't have to throw it out. Keep in front of the child and ask him to control. That is the impulse control. How he can control his impulses. And that can happen if a child is having a proper routine. Routine of exercise, routine of diet, routine of sleep, proper routine of interaction, expression. Now, maximum children, they are saying, ki why we are in mobile throughout the day for 15, 20 hours at home? Because parents don't know how to talk at home nowadays. They are not able to communicate during this pandemic because father was 9 to 9 outside. Now he's at home. Again, he doesn't know what to talk for 9 hours with the child. A young teen, she told me that day, she wanted to basically commit suicide and said, ki, you told me to talk to them. When I tried to talk to them, they said, ki, what topic we should talk? What are the topics? You tell us the topic now. What should we talk with you? Already because of pandemic, we are short of topics because nothing happening outside. Only corona topic is there. And second, again, parents, those who are not in basic habitual to talk with the children. So communication is a basic tool. Exercise is a tool. Dietary part, sleep, a proper routine, that will help them to control this thing and they feel, okay, we have something to play. So parents should know to play also with the child. Playing like chess, Ludo and other game, which we have all forgotten now. They should play with them. And not to lecture them in an elaborative way. Every parent wants to tell them, like generation X parent and Y wants to tell them how they were used to go on cycle and what was the cost of samosa at that moment. These children, they don't want to buy these stories. You were going on cycle for 20 kilometers and used to eat samosa for one rupees. They don't want to listen to all these things because they are born in the age of information age. They have seen the car on the day one of the birth. They don't want to think about the cycle.
Right. Excellent, sir. Thank you very much for answering all the questions with so much of explanation. And I'm very sure that, a lot of praises are actually pouring in the chat box. You can see, sir, very nice presentation. And thank you for, giving us this insight about such an important and very, very informative topic.
Permission to share the screen. I can just tell them
sure.
where they can do the course. Where
sure, sir. Sure, sure. Please.
I can show them. Just a minute, it will be over.
No issue, also, sir. Yeah, the screen, no issue.
Yeah. Sir, I would also like to request you to share your email ID if you can, like, so that we can also, our participants can contact with you if needed.
So they can go for the content moderator. And this is one thing which is coming up now, Neuro VR and Cyber Psychology. It's a conference there in abroad where Parkinson's and other things are taking, basically the specialists, they are taking help of cyber psychology to control the disease and disorder in that way. So now we have tied up with various universities. And there is one university called Rashtriya Raksha University. It's the only police university of central government. It's in the Ministry of External Affairs. And there you can go for online and offline. This time you have an opportunity to go for online course. Later on, it's going to be completely offline next year. So those who want to take an opportunity, they can go for Diploma in Cyber Psychology. Okay, so Diploma in Cyber Psychology is one course which they can go for 6 months course, online course, and they can avail from this. On 26, we are starting this course at Rashtriya Raksha University. Apart from this, we have our own institute called Central India Institute of Psychological Science. Basically, we have private courses there. But if you wanted to go for university course, you can go for Gandhinagar course. For international, we have with Dublin, Ireland, and we have IIIE Slovenia for digital psychology and behavioral economics. Even there, you can just put me a query and I can give you details about that. This is basically my number and the website of the university where you can just take a click of this photograph or something and you can connect with me. So those who wanted just to know more about course, not I'm selling it off on my patient or something. I'm talking about as a career, if you want to go for this thing, you can just go.
Yes, yes. Thank you very much, sir. There have been queries about that also. We are at the end of this session today. And thank you again, from the bottom of our heart. Thank you so much for conducting such an excellent session.
Thank you. So, thank you for inviting me.
Sure. We will definitely collaborate again in the future. Thank you again, sir.
Thank you.
So over to you, Dr. Prachita Vishwas.